But in the meantime, some other scary smart people just sort of look at the market reaction to this and trade. Forbes publisher Rich Karlgaard, market watcher David Benson. On the markets, I know more responding to trade, gentlemen, but not ignoring the uncertainty that could weigh on them maybe in the months ahead as a result of Mueller and this fine line or whatever you want to call it. David, do you first. Does this change your view of the markets? Is this noise that you don't want to hear?
No, it means absolutely nothing to me. And I honestly, Neil, don't think it means anything to the markets. And I don't just say that about today. I say that about every single day.
Graphics and musical packages to go with this. So that's okay. Just go ahead. Explain that.
I say it every single day since the special counsel was appointed and the huge rally up in 2017, all the volatility we had in 2018 around the Fed and around the trade war. The last thing markets have cared about was this special counsel investigation. And I'm not getting to my opinions right now about what Mueller did say and didn't say and where it goes politically, although I do have plenty of opinions I'd be happy to share with you sometime.
And I do want to hear them. Go ahead.
Yes, it's a non-event for markets. You have a 10-year bond yield at 2.25%. That's an event for markets.
Absolutely. And I want to posit that, as we said in the beginning, that's something that's palpable and real and presents a host of worries. What I do think, Rich, is that this added uncertainty of a summer-long hearings and the rest is something that Wall Street probably doesn't need or want in the middle of this trade imbroglio and the collapsing interest rate situation. Your thoughts?
Well, you have two historical examples. I mean, the 1973 and 1974 stock markets during Watergate were horrible. The market actually bottomed in August 74, the same time that Nixon resigned from office. But then you have the Bill Clinton example, and the market shrugged it off. I think trade is a much bigger deal. I'm not worried about falling bond yields, because I think technology has a much greater impact on inflation than a lot of people realize. Alan Greenspan has come around to that point of view, and you see it every day, the suppressive effect of technology.
You know, David, we did talk a little bit about, 10-year note collapsing now down to, 2.21%, the lowest in more than 2 years. It's so weird to see this inverted yield curve, because a lot of people look at it and say, all right, you're getting more bang for the buck, committing money overnight or 3 months than you would committing it for 10 years. And that usually leads to worrisome things. Are you worried?
Yeah, but I'm not worried about that per se, meaning the action itself. I'm worried about what's causing it. And I think that the reason for the declining bond yields is directly related to lower expectations around economic growth. Hmm. I see global trade collapsing, gross volume of trade, not just bilateral U.S.-China, but around the world, trade is dropping. The supply chain is very multilateral. There's a lot of actors being affected. And I don't think this economy needs this ongoing trade war. So it's sort of the collateral damage to that I'm worried about. And I think we see it showing up in bond yields over the last 3 or 4 weeks. I mean, Rich is completely right that there is a disinflationary pressure from technology on bond yields. I think that's a good thing. But nobody can believe that the curve inverting and that the 10-year being at 2.2% captures that. We need business investment. We were getting it the first part of the Trump administration's economic platform, and the trade war is taking it away.
So that trade war is going to be the big decider for this market continuing or not, Rich.
Yeah, it will be, and we have a real disconnect. Large company CEOs that lead companies with a global footprint have the negative sentiment for some months now. Small business owners within the United States and consumers feel very good about the economy. One of these two camps is wrong, but when you get to the size of investment, you probably tilt it more toward the large company CEOs who are seeing the impact of trade.
All right, gentlemen, I want to thank you both.